Today I am going to teach you one of the concepts in teaching, that is jigsaw method. As we all are aware about the jigsaw puzzles, those are given to the kids. They play the puzzles, there is a particular picture on it, like you dismantle it and they composite it again to frame that particular picture. Similarly, we shall have the same techniques in teaching. In this method, first there are four steps of this method: distribution of group and unit, then discussion, then interaction and compilation, and finally, of course, there should be an evaluation. So in the first step, you take the unit, you select the unit in which you will find the types of the units of it or the subunits of it. For examples, I have taken soil, the types of soil. Now I found there are four types of the soil. Now I will not teach about the soils in the classroom, but I will bring the material and I will give it to the students. So for that purpose, I will make four groups in the classroom, and one type will be given to a particular group. Not necessarily it should be four only, it can be many. It depends on the subunits and it depends on the number of students in the class. So first, for example, I will give first type to one group, second type to other group. In that way, I will make the classroom into four groups. So I will make them sitting arrangement separately, and I will give the material related that particular unit to that group. So after distribution of group and distribution of the unit subunit, then next phase is discussion. Now in second phase, student will read the material given by the teacher, and they will discuss among themselves about that particular concept. So students who understood best, they can explain to other students in the group. In that way, four groups will learn four concepts separately. This is about discussion within the group. Now here the third point, or the third phase of this method, that is interaction. Now see, in the second phase, every group understood their concept. Now in third group, from every group, one student will go to other group and will tell them what concept they have learned. So from every group, one student will go to another group and he or she is explaining her concept to the other groups. So they are called experts. So this is expert interaction with each other. Because here they have understood the concept, their concept separately, and now they are going to interact with it. Now here, all group students will knowing about one after one another concepts. So this is called interaction, group interaction with the help of experts. So experts with the students in this group who understood that concept in best group. So now here all students and all groups, they know the concept and the subconcept. After that, now the final is the compilation. Now the compilation may be, your teacher can tell them to present the concept in front of all the group, like here, like A group will present their concept, B group will present their concept. So in this way, they can present orally, or teacher can tell them to write on a paper and then submit it. And all the concept will put together, and that will be presented or that will be kept for the reading. So in that way, all the concepts will be learned by the student with the help of each other. And after that, the student teacher will conduct maybe MCQ test or maybe oral test. Because if you want to make all the learning seriously, you need to tell the student that there will be evaluation after it, or there will be test after it. So after the compilation of the concepts, evaluation will be conducted. And when the evaluation is conducted, teacher can say that all the concepts learned separately but interacted among them are compiled and they have learned that concept. So in this way you can say this is one of the way to collaborative learning or cooperative learning. Here students learn with themselves. It is the part of peer learning. Students learn with each other. Teacher need to provide a proper learning material to the students, so they can learn the concepts and they can interact. So this method is very useful for multicultural classroom or the classroom where there are too many conflicts. Suppose there are too many conflicts in it, so So here, when they are depend for learning on each other, so they need to interact with each other. So if there are many conflicts in the classroom, they cannot interact, and they know that if they do not interact, they will not go through the evaluation. That's why this method is very useful to make the cooperative learning in the classroom, where students can learn from each other and go hand in hand. Even this is also useful for the inclusive education, because there students, some students are slow in learning and some students are good in learning, or some students are physically challenged. So in that way, even they are, when they are learning in group, they can give positives to the group and they can learn with each other. So that is the beauty of this method, that students learn by friend, by with the help of their friends, with the help of their peers. And teacher here just monitors, teacher here just guide, and teacher just makes sure that everyone is focused and focus on that particular concept. So in that way, if you use this method in teaching and learning, so definitely students are going to benefit it. If you like this concept and if you like this video, please comments in the comment section, and also suggest for more topics so on which I can make more videos. Thank you.